Hi, welcome to Professor Matt, Electronics for Beginners. Today we are going to talk about capacitors. A capacitor is little like a battery. Although they work in completely different ways, capacitors and batteries both store electrical energy. There are differences. A battery stores energy in the form of chemical energy and converts it to electrical energy. A capacitor stores energy in the form of an electrostatic field. In a battery, chemical reactions produce electrons on one terminal and absorb electrons on the other terminal. But capacitors can't produce new electrons. Battery provides energy to the circuit. Capacitors draws energy from the circuit, stores and then releases the energy when it is needed. To understand the capacitor, let's look into an example. This is a water tank. It is connected to a pipeline. One end of this pipeline is connected to a rubber balloon, and there is a control valve to control the water flow. To convert the energy of moving water to work, we use a rotating wheel. Capacitor is like a rubber balloon connected to a water line like this. When the valve is open, water starts to flow. The balloon is expanded until the water pressure inside the balloon is equal to the water pressure in the tank. Now the balloon is also a water storage, like a mini water tank. Let's close the valve and disconnect the water tank. What is happening? The water is still moving until the balloon shrinks to its original size, because the water pressure inside the balloon pushes the water out. This is what happens in the capacitor. We call this the hydraulic analogy because various electronic components in a circuit are represented by the hydraulic equivalents. Here, the battery is equivalent to the water tank. Electric potential is equivalent to water pressure. The electric switch is equivalent to the water control valve. Valves control the water flow and switches control the electron flow. Here, the balloon is equivalent to the capacitor. We saw that a balloon can store water and supply it when the pressure goes down. Capacitors do the same job. They store the charges and supply them when voltage goes down. This is electrolytic capacitor. They have a negative pin and positive pin. Negative terminal is marked with a black strip usually. We can connect the capacitor to circuit parallelly like this. Negative terminal of the capacitor is connected to negative side of the circuit. And positive terminal of the capacitor is connected to positive side of the circuit. Let's replace the capacitor by its symbol for ease of understanding. A capacitor consists of two conductors separated by a non-conductive region. This is a non-charged capacitor. Here, red dots represent the positive charges and blue dots represent the negative charges. Since this is non-charged, the number of positive charges equal to the number of negative charges in each conductor plate. That means net charge is zero for each plate. So no electromagnetic force between plates. The electron pressure is zero for both. Let's name the plates as A and B and represents the net charge of each plate like this. Now we close the switch and complete the circuit. Electrons start to move. Look carefully. one electron is going into the plate A. Now the net charge of plate A is negative 1. This new extra electron can't go through the non-conducting region. So to balance this inequality, plate B releases an electron and becomes positive 1. The total charge of the capacitor is 0 now. But inside it has two plates. One has positive charge and other has a negative charge. It creates an electromagnetic force opposite to the incoming electron. But the force is not enough to stop the incoming electrons from battery. Plate A and plate B always have the same number of opposite charges. When the potential difference between the plate A and B becomes equals to the potential difference of the battery, we say the capacitor is fully charged. No more electrons goes to the capacitor. Let's try to open the switch and disconnect the battery. What is happening? Even though the battery is disconnected, the capacitor still has the potential to move electrons around the circuit. Plate A releases its excess electrons and plate B attracts the electrons at the same time. The electromagnetic force between plate A and B is going to be zero. We call this as capacitor discharging. Let's see again. When the switch is closed, electrons start to flow from the battery. Capacitor stores electrons. Capacitor is charging now. When the potential differences of capacitor and the battery are equal, no more electrons go into the capacitor. Capacitor is fully charged now. When we open the switch and disconnect the battery, the capacitor is still able to supply the current to the circuit until it gets discharged. This is a capacitor. One conductor plate has negative Q charge and other has positive Q charge. Due to this charge difference, the capacitor's potential difference between two plates is V. An ideal capacitor is characterized by a constant called capacitance, denoted by C. Capacitance is defined as the C equal to Q divided by V. Capacitance is the ratio of the positive or negative charge Q on each conductor to the voltage between them. Capacitance is measured using farads. A capacitance of 1 farad means that 1 coulomb of charge on each conductor causes a voltage of 1 volt across the device.